live before they did that number, because if you want tickets at the Broadhurst Theater, you should get them now before the show opens next week, because they will be sold out. Was that an amazing performance or what? Our next guest is a Broadway legend whose amazing performances earned her 4 Tony Awards before she was 34 years old. She was Bob Fosse's favorite leading lady, not to mention his wife. Take a look at the two of them dancing in Damn Yankees.
Who's got the pain when they do the mumbo? Who's got the pain when they go out? Who's got the pain when they do the mumbo? I don't know who. Do you?
Legendary, the amazing, the one and only Gwen Verdon. Well, hello, Gwen Verdon.
Hello, Rosie O'Donnell.
You're finally here.
Me too.
Been asking for 3 years now, and we finally
you
got it together. Yes.
Oh, great.
Now, when you did Sweet Charity at Lincoln Center, the
yes.
ovation, similar to today, was like 5 minutes. They wouldn't shut up. You finally turned to the audience and stopped. People, like, we were all, everybody's standing.
Yeah.
You're so amazing.
Well, I guess if you live long enough, that in itself is amazing.
How did the show come about? Was it basically your idea?
No, actually, it was Chet Walker's idea, and he spoke with Bob about 13 years ago, and then Bob died, but after about 3 years, I said, okay, the family's together. Come on, Chet, let's go for it. So
right.
we did, and we got Annie in, who directed the show, and put
right.
all the connective tissue in. So what do you know? There it is.
And it's brilliant. It really is. I saw yeah. backstage, I was watching a monitor while the dancers were dancing. You were watching a different monitor doing all the moves
I
as
know,
they were doing it. So you remember all the dances in your head.
Well, sometimes I have to check.
Yeah.
But most of the time, I'm like Pavlov's dog. You turn on the music, and the arms and legs just go.
Now, when did you first meet Bob Fosse?
About 1947.
Yeah. And where were you? Were you working together?
No, I was doing a show called Alive and Kicking, and he auditioned for it and didn't get the job.
Really? But you thought he was cute?
I kept saying to Jack, oh, but he's so cute. He looks just like Fred Astaire, which is not considered charming. I mean, handsome, but charm is better than handsome.
Right. And isn't it true that he was sort of being groomed to be the next Fred Astaire, but Fred Astaire never retired?
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
Now, when you were in Can Can, was that your first featured role on a Broadway
yes.
stage?
Yes.
And there's a story that I've heard that I wanted you to tell if it's true, that they asked you to sort of stop stealing the attention, because, well, tell everyone that story.
Okay, there was a judge's bench, a very high one, and they said, when Lilo is going to come in, you have to get and duck down. It would be like hide in back of your desk.
Right.
And I said, I won't do that. You know, so I turned my notice in, meaning I'd leave the show.
So you were going to quit, yeah.
Yes. And they said, no, you can't leave. Get behind the desk. I said, not me. That's, you can't do that to performers, any performer. You don't say, go hide while the leading lady comes in.
Yeah, and they wanted you to do that because that you were so fabulous and everybody was watching you. They wanted to give her some, is that the focus, right?
I think so.
Yeah.
She was fine about it. She never made that request.
Right. And then you turned in your notice, and the audience, you were hiding behind the desk.
Yeah. Oh, no, I would not hide.
Oh, you never did?
Never.
See, I heard a story that you were behind
never.
The desk, and the audience started chanting your name.
No, I had done a dance, and then the audience started chanting, we want Verdon. So I was in my dressing room making a change, and Michael Kidd ran from the back of the house all the way backstage, grabbed me, and I had a towel on in front, like that. And he dragged me out on stage, and I thought, I've never seen this set before. And I turned around, nothing.
You mooned him!
I mooned him.
And they loved you even more, probably. Now, you taught some amazing people to dance, Jane Russell and Marilyn Monroe.
Marilyn Monroe.
What was that like?
Well, first of all, Marilyn was not the dummy that people have suggested that she was. Anyway, she was terrific. All you had to do was contain her, because she really would just slurp. I don't know how else to explain it. And Jane Russell would say, Gwen, I can't do that. I'm not one of the little people. So I just trained both of them to get Jane to try to be like one of the little people, and to get Marilyn not to try to be sexy even sitting down.
Right.
I mean, she would sit down like this.
Yeah, yeah. So, she couldn't help it.
I know.
Now, are you going to do any more films? You were so wonderful in Marvin's Room, and we all loved you in Cocoon.
Thank
you. Are you going to be doing more films?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm doing, I just finished Bruno, which Shirley MacLaine directed, and I'm working on Walking Across Egypt, and that's why my hair is brown with streaks, because I play a nosy neighbor.
And nosy neighbors can't be redheads.
No.
I guess not. I adore you, Gwen, and it's an honor to have you here. I hope that you will sign this cover of Life magazine from 1959. There you are, looking gorgeous, as you do now. And the show is wonderful. It opens next week at the Broadhurst Theater. Fosse is the name. We'll be right back when I get weighed in. You don't want to miss that.
Oh.
Thank you so much.